The first place in Mumbai that I'm very emotionally connected with is Haji Ali, because I remember my first apartment that I had was in Worli, and straight out of my kitchen window I could look at Haji Ali, and there were times when I would go for a walk at night over there and just sit and listen to the sound of the ocean. Everybody talks about the spirit of Mumbai, and I think that has to be the best thing about the city. I'm basically a Delhi girl who then moved to Mumbai, but I've stayed here so long that I've ended up becoming a Mumbai girl, and I love it. Stay close to work, because traffic is terrible. Reach out to people in case you need help, because people are wonderful. And try street food, it'll never let you down. If you're to talk about one city you can't live without in Mumbai, yeah, the 3 months of the year that you need your umbrella and your gumboots, you better keep that ready through the year, because the rains are just, things can get messy. Mala, I didn't know what mala was, which was actually what floor, konsa mala. And I was just like, initially I was just like, okay, because we would say manzil in Delhi. There's another thing when you want to, but I've seen a lot of people when they want to get each other's attention, they do something like that, which is another Mumbai lingo thing. And thirdly would be Beda. I think Beda is egg. I still don't know. There was a time when my parents came to give an interview from Delhi, because I was getting my first rented apartment on my own, and I couldn't understand why they had to do it. Mainly because they were never going to live there with me. But yeah, I mean, they come with strict rules and regulations. It's definitely Worli, the sea face. It's definitely Marine Drive for me, because, you know, I look at the city differently at 5:30 in the morning when I go and run. I live very close to Mount Mary, so I go up the steps a lot, and, you know, there's a beautiful view of Mumbai from there. So those three places. But I get cravings in the evening, so I definitely call for Bhel Puri from, like, the guy under my building. I love South Indian food, so I like Madras Cafe a lot. It's a great one. There's also Swati Snacks, which is yummy, 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 fresh food. You know, there's Bachelors, which is street food, literally. There's also Amar Juice Center, so yeah, the basic one. There's a lovely restaurant called The Table, which is in town. There's also Bombay Canteen, which is nice. There's Nara Thai, which is very nice for Thai food. I love the energy when there's Ganesh Chaturthi, and he's, you know, he's so cute and like to look at. And Diwali is just lots of time with friends, family, playing poker, cards, and making lots of noise. And yeah, Christmas is usually quiet, and it's a one evening celebration. I watch pocket content on my phone. I travel by auto, I've traveled by cabs, I've traveled by public transport a lot. I haven't stepped on a local train except for when I was shooting a film called Ek Chalis Ki Last Local. You have people in abundance, traffic in abundance. The city gets a lot of sun, and I love that about this city. The condition of the roads, definitely. And I'm Neha Dupia, and for your daily dose of maximum city and maximum entertainment, log on to www.midday.com. Midday.com, maximum city, maximum entertainment.